Good afternoon. Welcome to Prophetic Saturday. Today is July 25th and I am Minister Flames of Fire from the throne room. Yes, I am excited to share the final episode on Prophetic Antenna. Yes, I hope that you have been blessed by part 1, part 2, part 3. Now this is part 4. This is where I close the deal. Yes, this is where I put the icing on the cake. And Prophetic Antenna, as I've been sharing in the last 3 episodes, about are we built with a spiritual antenna that we can use to hear the voice of God, that we can use the tuning to hear what God is saying. And we're in a season where it is very vital as us as believers that we are hearing God's audible voice. Yes, God's audible voice is speaking expressly through the airwaves, through frequency to us. But are we really hearing God's voice? How can it we know our wife's voice, or children's voice, or pastor voice, or boss voice? But why is it that when it comes to God's voice, it is so difficult for some of us? Hallelujah. So I'm going to share from my experience. As I said, we know that the Bible says that God speaks to Noah, God speaks to Moses, God speaks to Samuel. These are men like you and I. So why is it hard for you? Why is it hard for even myself sometimes, not saying that I hear God's voice all the time? Sometimes it's difficult, but because we're so distracted at times, sometimes we miss God. And I'm just going to give you some example of how God speaks to me. Glory be to God, because my Christian walk is based upon listening and tuning to the voice of God. Because I tell you, this journey is a marathon, it's not a sprint. And we have to be so careful with so much voice coming into our ear gate. Yes, our ear gate, our spiritual antennas. So many voices are coming in. Almost 60,000 voices we listen to on a daily basis. Glory be to God. How can we identify our glory to God, God's voice, that still small voice? That's how God speaks to us. And that's one area that I'm going to share on, our intuition. Sometimes we say, if my mind be telling me, we are going down one road, and we have voice said, don't go down that road, turn to the road. But what? You follow this road, and you go down there, something will happen. You meet an accident, you lost something, and she said, boy, my mind, they tell me when you go down there. So you know that, yeah, that's that voice. I remember one time, I heard the voice so audibly. You know, when I used to rent bunks about and hot dog machine and snow cone machine, a lady called me one time, and she wanted to rent my tent. Glory be to God. I know the voice said to me, don't go. You know, because as Christian, we have to be careful how we mix with certain sinners or what they're using your things for. Say, for instance, then you're a Christian in a business and you rent car. You have to be careful who you rent your car to. You're in a Christian and you do certain business. It's not every unsaved or unbeliever you have to do business with. And God is saying, listen, man, these people are going to use your tent. It was a round robin or barbecue or something like that, and she wanted to rent the tent. And the voice tell me, don't go. And I still get the tent, turn my car, go. People, when I gave the tent to her, my car start overheat. I couldn't even move from the location. Well, my car start overheat before me even reach. So when I reached there, I couldn't even go home. The car have to stay there till it cool down and mechanic come and fix it before I get home. So what am I saying? Hearing that still small voice that speak to you, you know, that first instinct, sometimes that is the first voice you hear. Another way God speak to us is through dreams and by angels. And you know, I've been sharing all of my testimony coming from episode 1, episode 2. I show you some of my testimony. And this testimony, I remember when we were still living in a rent house. We just got married. We were living in a rent house for about 2 years. And I remember I had 2 years, because my first 2 years in Christendom as a Christian, I was home. My wife was working. We just got newly married. We didn't have a job at that time. And I used to just stay in the presence of God at home during the day. I remember one time I was home praying, and I got a vision, an angel coming to my house in the living room. And he brought a box of shoes. And I like one big gold shoes. I can't even fit my foot in them. I said, what's this gold shoes about? I asked the angel. And it's a get ready, you're moving into a new ground, you're going into a new spot just by remembering that, how you know that vision. I'm just so grateful and humble, because about 2 weeks after, I think, or a couple, about a month or so after, you know, my wife saw an house on the internet, and she liked it, and we looked at it. This is with relief or faith. The word come. She didn't even know. I didn't even tell her, but she saw the house and she liked it, and she said, "On, let's go after it." We did not listen. We don't have any money. You understand? To find the first amount, I think it was like 35%. Or, you know, you have to find a certain amount of money. We don't even know where that come from, as I said. But God put it in place and sent people, destiny helpers, you know, when we share it with them, how they sow into our life so we could come up with the money and put the down payment. You know, we have our house for 3 years now. We extend on it now. So hearing the God voice, what is God is saying to your dream? What dream God is giving you? What vision God is speaking you to? Don't take your vision lightly. I always tell people, I always tell my wife and those around me, when you go in bed, go to bed excited. Some of us go to bed, don't care. Some of us don't go to bed excited. Carry your paper and carry your book. You know, like when you go back to school and you're excited, you have your new uniform and your new book and your pencil. When you go into bed, you have to get excited, because those are the times God speaks to man. The Bible says God speaks to his prophet through dreams and vision. And God also speaks to prophet and people through dreams and vision. Hallelujah to God. So God mouth is at all of us ears, and the next way God speaks to us is by a prophet, a man of God. Glory be to God. We see how the Bible says in 2 Chronicles, believe in the Lord and you shall prosper. Believe in his prophet, right? And you also shall be prospered. Glory be to God. So when a man of God speaks into your life, hallelujah, it is very critical that you pay attention to what the man of God is saying. Don't, because you are familiar with your pastor, you're familiar with a prophet, don't take his word lightly. The Bible says that Jesus says to the woman, he don't give his food to the dog. Hallelujah to God. But this woman says, even the dog eat from the scrums. There are people out there that are benefit from your pastor. There are people out there benefit, as I said, from your pastor. And you're not benefit from your pastor because you're familiar with your pastor. Whatever him says, like, you don't honor it, whatever the Lord speak to him. You know, you have to be careful, because you're blessing. What did Elijah say to the woman when he went to the woman's house? And he asked a woman what she have in her house, and she said, the oil and this and that. But she obeyed the word of God, and she went and she get the thing. And the Bible said she full up so much oil in that jar, and she have more than could all imagine. What am I saying? Honor your leader, honor your pastor, honor the voice that God is speaking through to you. Hallelujah to God. So I hope this message has blessed you. Because we're in a season. There's so many false prophets out there. So many people flinging out God's word. Don't care. They fling it out without a order. But is it really coming from the heart of God? Not because someone released a prophetic word. It is from God. Because guess what? Even lie is a prophecy. So many people are in prison because of lie. Because someone has tell lie in them, they end up in prison. So let us get to that place, people of God, where we can hear God's voice, what God is saying to us. And nothing's better than when God speaks to you and confirming through your man of God. That when he speaks, you can know and confirm that yes, you're a man of God, your pastor is hearing from God. And whoever that person is speaking to your life, because what it would have confirmed to what God have already speak to you in your prior time. This is Minister Flames of Fire. Thank you for coming along on this season. It has been handy. It has been a good season. You can go back and watch part 1, 2, and 3, and just let these words residue in your heart. And I pray that your ears will be open up now in the mighty name of Jesus, so we can be receptive and responsive to the voice of God. Tune in next time, next week, same time on Prophetic Saturday, where the heart of God meets the heart of His people. I'm Minister Flames of Fire. God bless you. See you later.